The Bible. It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how He created us and loves us so much that He made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. And now for an amazing story, inspired by the book of 1 Thessalonians, chapter 5, verse 18.
Ilse sighed as she trailed along behind her mom at the grocery store.
Can I just go wait in the car?
Mom handed Ilse a tiny loaf of bread to put into the cart.
You need to learn for yourself what you can eat.
Nothing. I can't eat anything.
Earlier that day, Ilse had gotten the food sensitivity test results back from the allergist.
No gluten, no dairy.
No artificial colors or flavors.
I don't even know what gluten is.
It's in bread and pasta and crackers and a lot of other things.
Ilse grabbed the loaf of bread.
Then what's this?
Gluten-free bread.
It looks like cardboard.
As they reached the dairy case, Ilse spotted the new holiday display.
Yes, they've got eggnog.
She reached for a carton, but Mom shook her head.
Eggnog has dairy in it, hun. You can't have milk. Let's try this instead.
Mom picked up a small carton and handed it to Ilse.
Soy nog?
By the time they got home to unload groceries, Ilse was miserable.
You've gotta be kidding. What about Sunday dinners? What about Aunt Ellen's stuffing and Grandma's rolls and pie and all the good stuff?
We'll find options for you, I promise.
Ilse reached for her plastic pumpkin full of candy on the counter. She grabbed a mini candy bar and then stopped, a sinking feeling in her stomach.
I can't eat any of this now, can I?
I'm sorry, hun.
When Ilse opened her lunch bag at school the next day, she tried not to groan. A sun butter sandwich with gluten-free bread, a bunch of grapes, a few carrots, and some weird-looking oatmeal cookies.
Where's my string cheese? Oh, right.
Ilse couldn't bring herself to finish lunch. Her stomach still felt empty as she settled back into her seat at social studies, where their teacher, Mr. Mendel, dimmed the lights for a slideshow.
One of the best ways to learn about other cultures is through something we all do every day. Any ideas what that might be?
Like what we wear?
Actually, I'm talking about something we do at least 3 times a day.
Ilse raised her hand.
Eat. We all eat.
Bingo! A famous photographer took photos of families all across the world along with the food that they eat in 1 week. I want you to pay attention to the details. This first family lives in Great Britain.
The first photograph included a family from the United Kingdom. The overflowing table of food included cookies and pizza.
Pizza.
Here's a family in southern Italy.
The next image showed a family with 3 small children. The loaves of bread on the counter looked so fresh, Ilse could practically smell the scent of baking bread.
Ooh.
This is Germany.
The next image showed another table top-loaded with food, but Ilse could only focus on the container full of ice cream front and center. Yet another thing she could no longer eat. Her stomach rumbled.
Here's a family in Bhutan. It's a small country beside India.
The next photo showed 12 people with a colorful display of vegetables, a large bag of rice, and a small amount of meat. Ilse frowned.
That's all they eat?
It's what they have to work with. This next photograph is from the country of Chad in Central Africa.
A family of 6 sat on the ground. In front of them, a tiny bag of grains, a small amount of beans, and a handful of vegetables.
Wait, where's the rest of their food?
That's it.
For a whole week?
Ilse shook her head.
That's just...
Ilse, what are you thinking?
I guess I knew that some people don't have the same things to eat that we do, or as much. It's just different, seeing it.
The colorful photos haunted Ilse for the rest of the afternoon. She was quiet as she took off her backpack in the kitchen at home.
You want a snack, hon? I've got some trail mix.
I'm good.
Ilse pulled her lunch bag out of her backpack and opened it up.
How was the gluten-free bread?
It was okay, actually. I'm going to finish my sandwich now.
Ilse took a bite of her sandwich and chewed. It wasn't like regular bread, but she could get used to it.
What's that thing Grandma always says before dinner?
What thing?
I don't... Before the prayer. It's the verse, like, say thank you, whatever happens.
Oh, it's from Thessalonians, I think.
Mom checked her Bible app.
Give thanks no matter what happens. God wants you to thank him because you believe in Christ Jesus.
Yeah, that.
Ilsa smiled and took a bite out of one of the oatmeal cookies.
Hey, these are really good. Thanks for making stuff I can eat.
Ilsa knew it would take some time to adjust her new eating plan, but she was glad for the reminder that she still had a lot to be thankful for.